fortunate to have Greta and Andrea here with us to answer questions about the film. And I will start with a question.
It seems as if there's one film within the film that you depend on a great deal, and I was wondering where you found that and what was the original purpose of that?
I think you're referring to the clip that opens and closes the film, the song Jump Children, which we use, the first half of the song we use in the opening and the end of it we use at the end.
When you're feeling low and you don't know what to do. When you're feeling low and you don't know what to do. Just stay in the groove, let nothing bother you.
Now the interesting thing is these films were really used for, they were called soundies, and basically, I mean, most people know about the Nickelodeon where you put a nickel in and you get to hear a song. If you put a dime in, a different machine, slightly different machine, you could see a little picture, and that's what these were. They were 16 millimeter films that you could see like on an individual basis.
Want to make something longer, or did you just, you know, think of it as a 30-minute?
Well, Greta, correct me if I'm wrong, but I seem to remember that we always thought of it as a half-hour film.
The film was meant to be told in their own voices. That was really important, that the rhythm of the edit and the rhythm of the voice of the film be a band. And so that's one reason we couldn't have, why these touched on a lot of these subjects or issues or problems or whatever, but couldn't go into, would have required going outside of their own voice, and I didn't want to do that.
The trumpet player, I think her name was Tiny Davis, she seemed like such a character. I mean, do you have any information about what happened with her after the...
We had to kind of restrain her because she could have easily have stolen the whole show.
On the sidewalk, Sunday morning, lies a body. Who's your wife? Someone sneaking round the corner. Hello, say.
Actually, when we were doing the research, I talked to all of the sweethearts, or one of us talked to each member of the band. Every single one of the women said, warned me about Tiny. What she might say, mostly I think what she might reveal about them. And Helen Sane said to me, you know, I'm a grandmother. So I'm like, okay, you're a grandmother. All right. So, but of course that makes it much more intriguing, so I was dying to meet Tiny.
Which reminds me, there were some others that we did find that were involved with the band throughout that whole period, and they refused to be filmed. They were happy to talk to us on the phone and give us their photographs and everything, but they were concerned about how much they had aged since the footage, and they didn't want to, you know, appear on film because of those concerns. So,
understandable concern. I understand as the older I get. But the other thing, Helen, the lead singer, Anna Mae Wynberg, when the film premiered at the New York Film Festival in 86, and we invited her to come up, and she came up with her daughter. Kind of gives me chills to tell the story. And the daughter sat in the balcony of Lincoln Center sobbing and saying, I never believed her. She has the dresses in her closet and would tell me about that she was a glamorous singer and I never believed her. So she was she had a very rough life in the 50s and 60s.
Was the lady that was interviewed the most, did she book the band, and was she the manager of the band, or was there someone?
Oh. No, it's briefly touched on in the film. You know, it started out as a school band. It was sent out to raise money for the school, but it was sent to places like churches and, you know, sort of respectable...
Aggregation.
respectable houses. And then the managers start realizing, wait a minute, I got this, like, gold mine on my hand. I'm going to book them into nightclubs. Well, most of these girls were, like, you know, they were still teenagers, really. And so there was a parting of the ways between the managers, who thought they could make more money booking them into nightclubs and sort of more, you know, risque venues and the school, which had a responsibility to the parents and so on. Because some of the girls weren't of age yet, they would take care of their finances and skim off some of it. I mean, if you asked them, they wouldn't say they were exploited. They loved what they were doing. It was a thrill of their lifetime. But if you were to look at it, just on a purely, on the spreadsheet, they were exploited.
These people who have these great memories of them, how did you locate them?
It was a event for Airmen Aerodynamics.
And there were all these, African-American old-timers who remembered the band there. So we pulled a few of them into the dressing room.
Yeah, I think we were...
Can we get a sentence from you?
I think it was just a paid gig we were shooting for them. And I found, and we realized that there were fans of the Sweethearts and bands, members who were playing that gig who remembered the Sweethearts, so we just turned the cameras around and took advantage of the opportunity of having those people there.
Can you say something about the importance of this film for you now?
Well, when I look at the Sweethearts now, I can absolutely see how much the cutting of the film, its relationship between music and image, has influenced my work over the last 20 years.
Greta and I went on sort of together and individually as well to make a lot of films that involve looking back and memory. And I'll just speak for myself, for me the whole digital video revolution changed that and made me much more interested in stories that are unfolding in front of the camera and sort of being more in the present.
Yeah, I think it was more than just the tech change in technology, but the change in financing. Because in some way, even though this film was on a shoestring, there's still like four different people who funded it, and none of those funders fund film anymore. So, you just have to look for other ways to make your movies, and when you do DV, you can actually.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.